We are looking at class 12, matrices, chapter number 3, multiplication of matrices. Just suppose that Meera and Nadeem, they are two friends. Now Meera wants to buy two pens and five story books, while Nadeem needs 8 pen and 10 story books. They go up to a shop and inquire about the rate, which are quoted like this: pen is for 5 rupees and storybook is for 50 each. How much money does each spend? So the simplest is 5. This is 5 each. So 5 pens, so 5 into 2 for Meera. And storybooks are 50 into 5. 5 into 50. 5 to 2, 50 into 5, this is 260 rupees Meera spent. Nadeem is 8 into 5 plus 10 into 50. So 540. When you want to represent this scenario, this information in matrix form, what you are going to write? This is the rates 5 and 50. This is what Meera needs, 2 and 5. Meera needs 2 and 5, 2 pens and 5 story books, and Nadeem 8 and 10. 8 and 10. Now, Meera and Nadeem, we wrote it in this matrix form, 2 and 5 and 8 and 10. So, and the price, the requirement is like this: the price per piece is 550. And the way we computed it is nothing but 2 into 5 plus 5 into 50. This is your first result, 260. Then 8 into 5 plus 10 into 50, that is 540. Now, suppose they inquire about the rates. I'm building the preface for the matrix multiplication now. Now, if the pen is 4 rupees each and the storybook is 40, we can replace this price per piece by 4 and 40. Now the result would be 2 into 4 plus 5 into 4. 2 into 4 plus 5 into 47. That is 208. And for Nadeem, 8 into 4 plus 10 into 40. That will be 432. I hope you got the idea. This information can be represented like this. We have replaced now with this previous amount with 4 and 40, and this is the result. This information is or can be obtained if you want to find out for these two prices per piece. The requirement of Meera and Nadeem is like this. This is the first price per piece, this is second price per piece. If you want to combine these cases, it will be nothing but 2 into 5 plus 5 into 10. You will write it here. Then 2 into 4 plus 5 into 40. We are dealing with Meera only. So Meera will need this much amount for this rate and this amount for this rate. Similarly, Nadeem, 8 into 5 plus 10 into 50. 8 into 4 plus 10 into 40. This is the required result. This example is the example of matrix multiplication. We just observed that two matrices A and B, the number of columns in A needs to be equal. This is very important. The number of columns of A, should be equal to the number of rows of B. And when we tried to find out the product matrix, we took the row of A and multiplied it with the columns of B. And then we multiplied each element means this element wise multiplication, and then we added them. So we took the sum. So we defined multiplication of matrices like this. The product of two matrices, this is the actual definition. This is the final verdict of what we have learned. The product of two matrices A and B is defined the number of columns of A. First of all, columns of A should be equal to rows of B. Otherwise, we cannot proceed for the multiplication. If A is m by n matrix and B is n by p, so this n, the column of A should be equal to the row of the second matrix. So the product of the matrices A and B, this matrix product, will be another matrix C, which you just found out as the final verdict for Meera and Nadeem. This is going to be equal to m into p. The order will be m into p. And if you want to find out to get the i, kth element, that is Cik, we have to take the i row of A and k column of B, multiply each element, them element wise. And then when you are, it means you have to sum the product. So you have to multiply element wise and then you have to find out the sum. In other terms, if you want to see it mathematically, if this is A, this is B, this is m into n, this is n into p, these two has to be equal. The ith row of any A, that is A, I1, I2, In, and the kth column, that is, this is the column. The result will be AI1 into B1K plus AI2 into B2K, like this, till you reach the end, and then you add them. So this is nothing but you can represent this addition with sigma j to j from 1 to n, from 1 to n, because this n is same, the column of the first matrix is equal to the rows of the second matrix, that is equal to n. So we are going from n 1 to n, aij into bjk. So the matrix C will be Cik m into p, the order will be, previous was m into n, and A matrix was m into n, B matrix was n into p. So you cancel this, m into p is the product of A and B. If we have C as this, D as this, and if you want to find out the product, first you have to check the order. So this is 2 by 3 and this is 3 by 3. So the product is possible. So you have to take element, this I'll show you, things element wise. Please understand, this is very important. Matrix multiplication is very important. First, you have to take this row and this column. So, first row, first column. So, 1 into 2 plus minus 1 into minus 1 plus 2 into 5. This is your first one. Then you have to take the first row and this second column. And you will go up to the number of columns. It can be 1 column, 2 column, n number of columns. Now, you multiply 1 with 7. Then minus 1 with 1 and 2 with minus 4 and you will write it here. Now how about this? 0, now you will take this. First, let us complete this. First row and second column, the value will be this. Now, this is done. So, all the columns are completed. Now you will move to the second row. Second row. Now this second row will be multiplied with, again, we will start with the first column. So, 0 into 2 plus 3 into minus 1 plus 4 into 5. This will be your result. Now this column is over, let us go to this column and we will remain with this row. 0 into 7 plus 3 into 1 plus 4 into minus 4 and this will be your result. So the final will be 13 minus 2, 17 minus 13. I hope you got the idea how you multiply the matrix. If you want to find out AB, this is 2 by 2 matrix and this is 2 by 3 matrix. 2 row 2 column, 2 row 3 column. So the product is possible. First of all, what we will do here is, see, I am writing the values directly. You just concentrate on this. First, we will take this row and this column. So, 6 into 2 plus 9 into 7. This is the first one. Then the row will remain the same until the columns are complete. Then 6 into 9 with this column. 6 into 6 plus 9 into 9. See. Then 6 into 0 plus 9 into 8, third column. But we are done with the first row. Now we come to the second row. 2 into 2 plus 3 into 7. See, 2 into 2, 3 plus 7, 3 into 7. Then the second column. 2 into 6 plus 3 into 9. 2 into 6 plus 3 plus 3 into 9. Then again, for this one, 2 into 0 plus 3 into 8. Just solve it. This is going to be your result. If A cross B multiplication is defined, can you tell me about B cross A? It is not always defined. Since the order is very important, the column of the first should be equal to the row of the second, right? This is very important, the column and row, if at all B and A has a value, say some order, such that the column of this first one, that is B, is equal to the row of A, then only multiplication is possible. And we'll see about the equality also. Non-commutativity of multiplication of matrices is just being discussed by me, that if AB and BA are both defined, even if AB and B are defined, that is A cross B and B cross B defined, A and B and B and A are equal, this is not always the case. So the multiplication of matrices is non-commutativity. If you commutate means moving around. So if you move around B and A, this is not going to be always equal. There may be case where it will be equal. Let us see with an example. We have A, we have B. We have A, we have B. Now, this is 2 by 3. This is 3 by 2. 2 row 3 column, 3 row 2 column. So when you take AB, 3, 3, so the column of A is equal to the row of B. So this is possible. Again, if I take B into A, this will be, if I take B into A, this will be 3 by 2 and this will be 2 by 3. Again, the column of B is equal to the row of A. So BA is also possible. Let us find out AB and BA and let us see whether AB is equal to BA. You know now, I'll show you AB. I hope that you will be able to do BA. A into B is, we are writing these two. So 1 into 2 plus minus 2 into 4 plus 3 into 2, first one. 1 into 3 plus minus 2 into 5 plus 3 into 1, second one. Now we come to the second row. Minus 4 into 2 plus 2 into 4 plus 5 into 2. Now second column. Minus 4 into 3 plus 5 into 2 plus 2 into 1. So this value you get. Now let us come up to B into A. And you know how to find it out. You see this is the result where AB and BA are not equal. AB and BA, they are again of different order. So AB and the values are also not same. But it may be possible that AB and BA are equal. I am not saying that they may not be equal anytime. Right? Let us see one more. A and B are like this. This is 2 by 2. This is 2 by 2. So their order are same. They are of equal order. AB is given like this. BA is given like this. Clearly we have AB which is not equal to. You see these two are not equal. They are not equal. So the multiplication of matrices is non-commutative. And as I said that AB not equal to BA, this does not mean what we have learned, that AB not equal to BA for every pair of matrices, AB, which A and B are defined, this is not always the case. See, A is this, B is this. AB and BA both are equal. As I just said, that there may be possibility. You see an example right now, that the multiplication of diagonal matrices of same order will always be commutative. These are diagonal matrix, means these are 0. These are 0, the diagonal elements are there. So when you multiply A with B or B with A, you will get the same value. So the multiplication of diagonal matrices of same order will always be commutative. That is, you get AB equal to BA. Zero matrix as the product of two non-zero matrices. We have known that for any real number A and B, if AB equal to 0, then either A has to be 0, or B has to be 0. What we write? X minus 1 equal to 0. What this means? Either X equal to 0 or X minus 1 equal to 0. We equate. And for matrices, this may not be true. I am not saying this is not true at all. I am saying this may not be true. We'll see with an example. If AB, A is this, B is this. Now, I multiply A and B. 0 into 3 plus minus 1 into 0, I get 0. 0 into 5 plus minus 1 into 0, every time I'm getting 0. 0 into 3 plus 2 into 0, again 0. And 0 into 5 plus 2 into 0, 0. So we are multiplying A and B, which are not by themselves zero matrix, but the product is zero matrix. When we are dealing with the multiplication of matrices, we need to see the properties also. So the multiplication of matrices, there are certain properties. The associative law, that is ABC, if you multiply AB, these are all matrices, multiply AB and the result with C, that will be equal if you multiply BC and then multiply with A, when both sides of the equality are defined. Distributive law is, you have B plus C and you have multiplication here, so you can do A dot B, that is A cross B, then you add A cross C. Here again, AC, BC, you can add that. The existence of a multiplicative identity, for any, you need to know that for this you need to have a square matrix. For every square matrix A, there exists an identity matrix. If you multiply I identity with A, or you multiply A with identity, you will always get back the result as the same matrix. Let us verify these properties. This is A, this is B, this is C. Now A cross B cross C means this first, this first. Let us see whether they are equal or not. AB, now I hope that you will be able to solve it, is this. Then you multiply AB, the result of this, with C, you get this result. Now let us take the right hand side part. BC, this get the value of B into C. Then we multiply A with B into C. A with B into C, we get same result as we got with this one. So these two are equal. If A and B and C are like this, you need to calculate AC. First of all, you have to multiply these two, then these two, and you have to perform, you have to add these and multiply with C. And you have to verify this. So A plus B, you can just add them. A plus B into C, you multiply this result with this, you get this. Then AC, of course, BC, and when you add them, you get the similar result. This is the verification of the property. If A is this, A cube minus 23A minus 40I equal to 0. 0 is nothing, 0 is nothing but 0, but we will get a 0 matrix. So A cube can be written like this. First we will find A square A, that is A into A into A. So we multiply A into A then with A. So A into A is this. A into A with A, that is A cube, will be this. A cube minus 23 into A, this is scalar multiplication of A, with minus 40 into I. I is the identity matrix. When you add them, you get 0 matrix. 0, 0, 0, all these zeros. In a legislative assembly election, a political group hired a public relations firm to promote its candidate in three ways: telephone, house call, and letters. See, the cost per contact in paisa is given like this. So the number of contact of each type made in two cities, X and Y, is given like this. This is X, this is Y. Telephone call, house call, letter. You have to find the total amount spent by the group in the two cities X and Y. So how to find this? You need to take the multiplication. So you have to multiply, this is X, this is Y, and you just have to perform B into A. B into A, this is A, this is B. You have to perform B into A to get the total amount spent by the group in the two cities. So B into A, you can find out this is the value. So the total amount spent by the group in two cities is 3400, this much paisa, you can divide it and give it in rupees, and this much, 3400 and 7200 rupees. So this is another part of a very important chapter, matrices. We'll be taking more. Thank you so much. Take care of yourself.